Alright, so I'm at 7, 6, 5.
A second ahead, and let me get up.
Alright, good enough. Quick. So we've just joined at a very sort of clutch situation right here. overtime with 1 point in it. Seems as though Kairos is... Wait, no. Kairos was the others.
Right. It's Borks versus Kairos.
Borks versus Kairos. All right. Yeah, I was a bit confused there. Yeah, so we saw a 59-58 right there. That was... I'm sure that was an exciting match, for the 10 seconds that we got of it.
Right. So let's see, that would have been map 3, and looks like that was it.
Alright, well, people are leaving? Or are people subbing?
Wait, no, that was the first map. It's Tower Control.
Wait.
Bluefin. Wait, what did we watch for the first map of the last round? Because I don't remember it being Bluefin.
That wasn't Bluefin. No, it wasn't. It definitely wasn't. It was Walleye.
That it was. All right.
Okay.
All right. All right. That I guess that is the penalty for starting so early. The wrong map gets played. Everything else was right, though.
I don't know. Yeah. So we've got some subs coming in here. Kairos has swapped out, I believe, Splugy for Crab? And it looks like Regen's coming in for someone else. I didn't see who dropped out. Anyway.
And that would make sense, swapping out your Charger main. For, I think... Rollers, what Crab usually does.
Oh, this is interesting. We are seeing a vanilla heavy right here.
That is interesting. Especially as the Ink Strike isn't particularly helpful, at least for covering the zone for bridge zones. It'd be fine for
maybe his...
pressuring chargers or that backline.
I'm just thinking perhaps he's... intending on playing sort of across the map rather than along the bridge, because like with that kit, as you say, the Ink Strike isn't amazing, but when you have the walls, it's really good for playing across the map, and also the Ink Strike is actually quite effective at like Ink Striking one side of the zone while you're pushing from the other side, which would again sort of imply that he might be aiming to move across the zone. That said, he's still a Splatling with a ton of run speed, so he's going to be rolling out straight down the mid. That's, you know, standard fare. But he's getting smacked by the carbon. That's classic red deck right there.
Yep, red, always in your shadow.
Yep. He's just going to sit tight in that bunker and wait for people to come to him, because people always seem to be willing to challenge the carbons. And they have, like, toothpick range. There's nothing they can do to me, surely. Famous last words. But we see Kairos with a solid lead already, getting down toward the 50 mark. Gamer is trying to get his Ink Strike set up. That should be enough to stall the timer once they start pushing in.
Looks like he is opting to go to that side, and it's taken up by Maxi.
So yeah, that's a solid trade for Kairos. Usually you wouldn't want to be trading the Octo for the Spartling, but... And on that defense, the Ink Strike was probably one of the main tools they wanted to use to get back in, and it's down to 12 points. They've got the timer stopped. I have to see what they can do with this. Sprinklers proving difficult for them.
And a range blaster. And a red in your shadow.
Yep.
Keeping that zone nice and safe until they're able to recap.
So it's a 3v2 right now. They might have a chance to stop the push once again. Yes, they do at 3 points. It's going to be a solid penalty if they can get it, and it looks like they do have the numbers advantage on the zone, or maybe not once Duel region.
Red's
no,
in there,
region.
Keeping it close, and that's it.
That's it. And Kairos bounced right back after that 1 point loss with a solid knockout on the zones. Interesting team comp coming out here from... Borks. I keep forgetting. looks as though the Dynamo was basically playing paint control, which you know, you always like to see with a dynamo. And
yeah, but tricky to do on a zone that skinny. You don't get the same kind of advantage as you get for the more square zones with the dynamo.
Yeah. But again, though, like, the sprinkler, like, you could see that they had the sprinkler on the wall, and I think that, I don't know if you've seen that that clip of a carbon roller trying to paint the Mahi-Mahi zone against the sprinkler and not winning.
I could believe it.
Oh, dear. That, I get the impression that may have been happening at some point. Obviously not with the carbon, but... Yeah. Anyway, we've got Splooge back in. So Crab has popped out. We won't be seeing Dynamo on Rainmaker or Arowana. Surprisingly enough, I mean, it is quite effective here. have to see what Gamer goes with. He is known for using basically all the weapons, as you can see on his on
fine
his weapon
mix here on the first page.
Yeah. Going with the Vanilla Mini. Interesting.
Very good for popping Rainmakers.
Very good indeed, yeah. And the Zook is also excellent on Arowana. So many angles that you can use. Great for picking people off the top ledges. Oh, and he's just going to change everything up. I don't know. I gotta say, I find Gamer's gear very interesting. It seems as though he has two run speed pures, like, at least headgear and shirts or something like that. I don't know.
Well, what, you have to stay fresh with that. You just can't go
apparently.
Your appearance willy-nilly, you have to make it all match.
And then he uses this shirt for whatever reason. Anyway. So, yeah, they're going to be rolling out to closed. Usually we see Zinc Minis trying to build bubble early on, especially on Arowana, where you can sort of strafe along the sides of the map and just paint down in the lower area. He does manage to get the clean kill on Maxi, so that's going to be helpful for them, but the mid-air direct from Splooge, not direct, that's a elitop shot. It looked like a direct, with the jumping CRB just sort of chilling.
Yep.
And yeah, here we go, we see the more standard Zinc Mini play here.
With the bomb rage up, I think he was opting for sacrificing the first push, giving it to the other team, and instead having the disruptors there to halt any push that they would make. Which would kind of make sense for that position and not building up.
Yep, and we see, well, he's
just eats a shot or
two. Between a rock and a hard place, there's a blast from one side and an E-leader with no scope on the other side, just holding his charge, waiting for it. And they do have the Rainmaker, so they're going
to
start.
He's able to get past that bit of ink. He can make a break for it. Oh, but Red's there.
But
he's
yeah.
really been waiting.
Red with them. Yep. Carbon Roller doing Carbon Roller things. He's going to be sharking that Rainmaker. Hopefully for Kairos, they'll be able to stop that push nice and quick if it does get snuck away from them. Yeah. You can see Gamer is definitely on, well, I was going to say he was on defense duty and then he jumped into a Rainmaker Tornado. It's very unfortunate. I think that was just sort of wrong place, wrong time. You could see what he was trying to do and
just got caught by the tip of the Rainmaker shot.
Always hate that. You always, like, on some maps, especially actually Arowana, because you can get that height difference. Like, you sort of feel like you can jump over the Rainmaker shots and, like, yeah, I'm gonna just jump over and, like, do a ninja thing, and then. And it seems like a great idea at the time.
Very lucky shot from his teammate.
Excellent. Whoa, I mean,
very
calculated
nice.
Too.
Oh, yeah.
Very good push coming out. Oh, with save, we have Red Vec coming in. I noticed too the Borks has gone with their own carbon roller, perhaps not taking kindly to Red Vec shenanigans. we do appreciate some good carbon roller play on Weapon Spoon.
I mean, I'm sure everyone enjoys a good carbon roller.
Yeah. They definitely do. 100%.
100%.
No salt whatsoever.
totally
bomb
not
range
sarcastic.
Coming like it. Oh dear. Well, I can see the burst bombs going off in mid, and I think Gamer did too, so he's just backing the hell out of there. carbon rollers are very obnoxious for zinc mains. Or zinc mini, sorry. Just don't want to be losing that bubble with the heavy depletion.
Seems that Borks is just going to kind of wait this one out and see what Karus has to offer. Just building up specials and sitting on them.
Yeah, they have every right to. I mean, it's not as though...
Yeah, 4 would definitely be a hard one to come back through, especially with the amount of control that they have on their side.
I think I would prefer to see a more forward hold, but at the same time, like, when Gamer can just do that. Just with the team bubble, and does go down to Boo, but his teammate does trade him off. Boo with the defense build on CRV, interesting. Normally that's more of a custom blaster build, because that's sort of... the defense is more likely to come into play against, like, the Gals and the T-Techs that can actually shoot you.
Right.
But fair enough with the defense. And Haunt as well, so, like, he's sort of going all in with the defense there. But they are trying to make a sneaky push here. It looks as though it's gonna get taken up.
Don't quite have the coverage for it.
Yeah. With this amount of coverage, and it doesn't look as though anyone on Borks is doing anything terribly aggressive, so it doesn't look like there's going to be any accidental throws coming in.
It does seem that they don't have control of that close, which may bite them very soon.
That Zooka was potentially... Oh, never mind. They lost the Rainmaker with 5 seconds left, so it's basically over. Yeah, well played though from Borks. Bit more of a conventional Rainmaker push there compared to our last game on we were watching with Hanron. And that is going to be 2-1 to Borks. Apparently Gamer did in fact leave Kairos. Okay, interesting. So, moving on to TC Piranha Pit. Fully expecting that Gamer will stick with the... Well, then again, Gamer does do Gamer things sometimes. Might be going with the Stealth Jump. I can see why, too. Stealth Jump on Piranha Pit's quite useful for the... fact that it does have very long sight lines, and you do quite often want to be jumping into teammates, especially on the sort of spawn camp hold when you're pushing in. Going with more of a run speed build instead of the bomb range. Fair enough again. With Arowana, you're sort of wanting to get the bombs sort of up and over into mid, which can be difficult without bomb range. Like, you have to be very, very close up, and you sort of in range of getting dunked by carbons in that case, but on Piranha Pit, you're more looking like just... like, it's all flat ground, basically. The longest, or the farthest distance you're going to be throwing these disruptors is just, like, onto the ramps or whatever to try and stop Red from jumping off the ramps and...
being a Skyroller.
Yep, Skyroller. it's a shame you can't, like, put, like, you know how you can do, like, Flynamo, like, with quick respawn, quick super jump dynamos? You can't really do that with Carbon.
Yeah. Or at least it's not as impressive. You might get one.
Yeah, and it, like, the name doesn't work either. Like, you can't call it Flygon, or, you can call it Flygon, I guess, but that just makes no sense. That's also a Pokemon. It's, like, not at all related to Splatoon. Gamers, oh, that's a very impressive push actually coming out from Kairos already.
Yeah, it seems that Borks is getting caught into a single file line straight into all of Kairos.
Yeah. Yeah, it did look like that. They probably could have held off for like a 10-15 seconds, and like maybe they would have pushed to 40 after all, but they probably wouldn't be pushing to 10 like they have done already. This might be a straight up knockout. Like, just one and done. That's a full wipe from Kairos, and
it is.
Very well played. Just one and done. 100% death push. So that's 2-2. For now, very quick equalizer.
An exciting match in Zones Mahi.
Yeah, hopefully we get to see that solo carbon trying to ink the zone against a sprinkler. I somehow doubt it.
Yeah, I don't think...
I need to find that.
Red will spend too much time in the zone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
Oh, gosh. It's, wow. Like, the carbon can't even get the zone neutral. That's the dumb thing. Like, when it's painted, the carbon, like, comes in and is just trying to paint the entire zone. Just can't do it. Just ticks down to zero. It's just the saddest thing. Surprised they aren't bringing Crab back in, Kairos. They had him in for Hammerhead zones, but they don't seem to be bringing him in for Mahi. That's normally the Dynamo is very common here. Arguably the strongest weapon on this. Are we seriously seeing Reaper? Okay. Interesting.
Remy could work. Definitely has the capping potential.
Oh, absolutely. I'm not saying it's
what I would have picked.
Yeah, it's not at all a bad idea. It's one of those weapons that it's kind of awkward to build for, just because you kind of want bomb range, you kind of want the sub saver, you kind of want the damage, you kind of want the run speed. Like, there's a lot of things that you kind of want, so
you
have to make
them all. So you have to sacrifice some.
Can't have them all. But at the same time, with the burst bomb buff from several months ago, the burst rush is extremely good at painting the zone. Perhaps not quite as good as, say, a suction rush, because the suction rush, like, not only paints the zone but also forces the enemy team away from it. Whereas the burst rush kind of doesn't. Yeah. But the burst rush does suddenly get more paint down. So that'll be something to look out for.
Battery's just showing off.
Indeed. Very well could be the case. I have to say, Boo is just triggering me by the fact that he's using that bloody power armor helmet. I just see it spawn, and I'm like, please, please no. Meanwhile, well, apparently...
This is an interesting way of using those burst bombs, sitting further back and just letting bomb range hike it over. I would have expected him to be more on the floor.
Yeah, he actually almost got the kill there on the guy sitting behind box. I didn't see who that was, but Boo showing that custom range blasters are kind of a good weapon on this map, and just taking him out of that perch area. They seem to be having a carbon infestation problem right now. great. We get to see the burst rush get taken out. Smart by the Octoshot, who also takes out the Kraken coming in. That said, Hawks did manage to get the zone, so even if only for a split second. And, well, they've come back again. Maybe the zoning burst rush was just enough. Did somebody just fall into the water? No, never mind. I just saw a squid, like, fall into the drink.
Flash is showing the power of shooting around corners.
Yeah, it's quite an effective thing to be able to do. Just ignoring the stage geometry.
Oh, suddenly red.
Oh, that is the most triggering thing about rollers. Is just like
they'll sit in the smallest pool of ink, waiting for you.
Yeah, and then like they jump up and like you shouldn't be able to die up that ledge like that, but you do, and then it's like you're just sad after that. And terrible.
Yeah. Anyway, probably a more expensive play than I was hoping to see.
Oh, he...
A few too many indirects on the defense main boo.
Yeah, that's the defense definitely was coming to play there. And you can kind of see why the Reaper has its problems. He probably wanted the damage there so that wouldn't happen, but unfortunately he can't fit any into his build, so yeah, whatever. So, we see Booze getting holed up on the left side of the map. And again, you can kind of see that, yet again, the sort of refurbs kit. It's a bit awkward. You can't really do the burst combo, burst first, you have to shoot first, and then burst later.
Although, I found in my experience, doing that combo, it seems much more prevalent on the Remy than the other burst bomb weapons. The burst kill, doing shot then burst, tends to have a bit of a delay on it for the hit confirm. And for something like a blaster, that can be a devastating few frames where you, what would have been a kill in your favor ends up being a trade.
Yeah, absolutely. And you can see again the damage up, or the lack thereof, is on the horn. Gamer right here. That said, they do get the zone. Very well played. There's burst bomb battle going on, and there you go. Sploosh shaken out. CRB's next.
The defense comes
CRB's in. Next? No, it's not. Okay.
He thought he had it, but the defense said nay.
Yep, and Boo with a close range direct. Always interesting with CRBs. Like, you sort of figure rushing down at CRBs are a great idea, but then the directs at close range are actually quite easy to do, oftentimes. And Boo coming in with yet another direct, very well played there.
Seeing a lot of Boo this match.
We are indeed. unfortunately, with that bloody hat that he has on. Oh, gosh. Oh, he does get the trade with Red. It is even numbers right now, but at the same time, the penalty has ticked down. They are starting to gain some real points now.
Yeah, but that's so, way too many down on Borks. This is going to go to Kairos.
Most likely, unless he can pause the zone. Yeah. He got it paused, but the burst rush was a little too late. So that's a 3-2 for Kairos. Very well played back. These guys might even be the top two in their group, just based off this, because Kairos usually does tend to do quite well. And the fact that Borks did take them so close. Very good to see. Great match.
Alright, so let's see. We should be wrapping up some round one matches and starting into round two now. So let's see if we can find someone else. Let's see. We got some more Kairos. We have Jappas. I didn't know Senda was playing with them. That's fun. That's Tic Tac's team, if I remember right.
Yeah, it's sort of the late night Japanese scrim group.
Yeah. Let's see. We also have Hokusai Squad, or the Oviedo Hokusai and Oviedo Ryohai. I'm not sure if Ryohai's streaming though. And of course, Katsui. Let's see what Katsui's doing.
Oh boy.
Who's Katsui playing? Where'd you go? Where's what's up? They will be playing Deep Blue soon. They just finished up against Chibi Squid Squad in a 3-0. So yeah, let's go tune in over to Cats. And we'll just wait out that lobby for round two. Assuming this is just a squad battle.
Yeah, it is.
Because that's not on any of the round two maps. Can never be too sure after after Pleasure.
Yeah, I mean, you sort of just, you see Flan to Rainmaker and you're just like, yeah, that's almost certainly the rotation, because it always is.
Yep.
Never did quite understand why Flander Rainmaker is the most picked Rainmaker map. I'm pretty sure it's Warlife for the other two modes, but it's this map for some reason on Rainmaker.
Does that mean it's almost time? Probably no better faction.
I thought it was a solo queue game. Okay.
Oh, even better. Even more exciting. Alright, so while we have a moment, let's run through.
Oh, apparently Chibi Squid Squad dropped.
They did. I'm just not seeing that too. Which would make sense while they're just hanging out playing squads. So they effectively had to buy that round. I didn't have a refresh. There we go. Now I see all the scores. I was getting concerned as only seeing like two scores entered in. So we have Kairos, of course, taking 3-2 against Borks. Xerox 3-1 against Caramel Kitties. Get Kraken 3-0ing Evolution. And Wipeout 3-0ing Ovioto Ryohai, who seems to also have dropped. Maybe? I'm not even sure anymore.
No,
it was just
I'm not
Chibi.
Seeing them.
Yeah, it's just Chibi Squid Squad and it just happened to line up that way.